shit later. Yeah. Give me a round of applause if you're pro-choice in this room. Yeah. That's goddamn right. Say what you want about the Yeti, but there are no bad parents here, are there? No. We left those critters in the goddamn dumpster from Planned Parenthood, didn't we? Raise a drink. That's good. People aren't listening. That's fucked up. I like it. I'll be honest with you. I hate Planned Parenthood. I do. I'm not a Republican. I'm just trying to get someone pregnant. They keep telling me gingers are going extinct, so I've been poking holes in condoms, dating Catholic girls, thinking they would never get an abortion. But a week with me takes you from pro-life to pro-choice real quick. Fuck my set list. I'm going over here. Hey, y'all. Upset me because I can't fucking maintain one, but fuck them, right? Fuck the home. No.
Yes. No.
He agreed. Let me tell you a true story. I saw a homeless guy the other day. I gave him $5, and he was super happy. When I handed the money, he flinched, and I was like, "What's wrong with you, sir?" And I saw his sign, and it said, "You can punch me in the face for $5." And I felt bad. That is a human being out there. That is a man struggling. He is being degraded. He is being tortured every day. And I'll let you know this. Punching him didn't make me feel better about it. But I did it anyway. Because I'm not going to waste that money. Hey, you guys in a relationship?
Yeah. Not yet.
It's about to be at the Yeti. Oh, that's cute. I love seeing couples form at the Yeti because you guys are going to see each other in a week and pretend you don't know each other. That's the best. And then you're going to call her in 2 weeks explaining the chlamydia call. That's fun because it's prevalent here at the Yeti. You're welcome. I did that. And that's all right. I'll be honest with you, I don't actually have chlamydia, but I thought I did. I thought I did. I had a downstairs problem. And that's a weird thing to go to the hospital for. When you're a guy and your balls have trouble, you don't want to admit it. It's like a failing relationship. I went to the internet. All I saw was the worst. I asked my friends for vague advice, and it said try an open relationship, but that didn't seem productive. At all. So I went there, and I remember I had my fingers crossed. I was like, chlamydia or cancer, fingers crossed, cancer! Because that's a phone call I can make. You can get pity pussy. That's a new word I just made up. Everybody, write that down. Pity pussy. You can get pity pussy from cancer. Not from chlamydia. People get mad at you. Have you ever gotten an STD test and you say, run that back? Have you ever had a doctor look at you and say, you look like the kind of guy that sleeps with the girls no one else will? I bet you hanging out the Yeti. And I said, that's not nice. I'm not gonna pay this bill. I wasn't anyway. You don't have to. Healthcare's free if you don't pay for it, people. I'm just letting you know that. You don't have to pay. The emergency room visits, just ignore the way your letters. Just keep going. I like that. Hey, why does everybody pretend Godsmack wasn't a really big part of our lives 10 years ago? Say what you want. I was gonna write this joke about System of a Down, but I'm at the Yeti. So if I was talking shit about System of a Down, 9 people here would be like, but what's wrong with System of a Down? He gets it. He's the Black Serge Tankian. I get it, man. I can't wait to finally tell people I have a black friend. That's you now. We're going to have an awkward handshake later. Cannot wait! No, Godsmack was never the one so far away. When you felt that snake bite into your veins, never did you want to be here again. And you don't remember why you came. That's what you're gonna say later. Hey, did you guys know that song's about heroin, by the way? That's a fucked up drug. I've never done it, surprisingly. Raise your hand if you ever smoked crack. I'm so proud and disappointed at the same time. I'm like my dad when I brought home a C. What's wrong with you? You're just doing your best, and I get it. What's fucked up is everybody knows somebody that tried crack once, and they're really good at telling you crack is awesome. I don't need to hear that. Hey, Yeti, who here likes blowing their paycheck on cocaine, though? I recently watched a documentary called Gordon Ramsay on Cocaine. Not as cool as I thought it would be. I thought I finally have something in common with a celebrity outside of Paris Hilton, because I'm ruining Tulsa for everybody. Didn't get a laugh, but it's true. Just needed to get that out. That's a confession. Here's the thing. Gordon Ramsay himself went down to Cambodia to show you what's in cocaine. And it's fucked up, people. Remember this as a PSA. There's cement mix. There's dirty Colombian people feet. And that's gross. Other stuff. But the way Gordon Ramsay describes things, my nose was watering by the end. Solid joke. Hey, did you guys know I carry a suicide note in my pocket everywhere I go? Because whenever I die, I don't need people here saying I'm bad at doing drugs. No, whenever I overdose, it's gonna be awesome. That got darker than I meant it to. Really just fucked up that joke. But anyway, cocaine's not addictive, everybody. It's just always a really good idea. And I'll tell you this about cocaine. The only problem is it makes me admit to fetishes I do not have. I'll be in a girl's studio apartment 2 blocks up saying, "Aw, go ahead, pee on me." But I date the kind of women that can't afford to keep their water bill on. So I'm using the chamois on the back of her toilet to wipe off my liquid chain, trying to figure my life out. And I'll leave you on this joke. Ladies in the room, despite what you just heard, I'm a gentleman. I don't send dick pics. Ladies, can I get some applause for that? Not sending dick pics, that's a nice thing, right? All the ladies like, fuck it, we're the Yetis, send them, let's go. Let's have a good time. Let's see what you got, what you're working with. Anyway. I sent dick portraits, and you better believe they're themed. Pixar, for that matter. I like to tie some balloons to it. I'll call it Up. Tug at the heartstrings. Yeah. You're struggling too, man. I get it. I like to get up. Alright. I like to buy astronaut helmet, moon background. My ex loved it because she said she faked it too, whatever that means. I call it the Buzz Lightyear, which means I trim it like once every 6 months. Otherwise, you're like Moses and you're talking to the burning bush, which is alright for me. I like to get a cowboy hat, write Andy on the balls for authenticity. I call it the Woody, which is unoriginal, but I still like it. That joke's really not that good. But I'll leave you with this. I love single moms. Is that Tate? Of course it is. Of course it is. My brother from another single mother. That's fun. I like single moms. They're used to disappointing men and children. And I'm a 2-for-1. And they're used to couponing. I'll tell you this. If you ever want to find the best nightclub to meet a single mother, do yourself a favor and check out a cosmetology school. One laugh, I'll take it. My name's Nicholas Osborne.